Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Commodity TV and a new edition of our online interview update series. Today, we want to talk to John McConnell, who's the CEO of Victoria Gold. Hey, good morning into the Yukon, I should say, actually. John, how are you doing?
Yeah, no, good morning, everyone. I'm doing well, despite the times we live in.
Yeah, that's the only thing, that's right. But yeah, we got also some sunshine here today and 20 degrees. I love it. That's fantastic. Okay, let's super. Let's come to your terrific company. I mean, you guys went on 1st July last year into commercial production. You faced some hiccups. You came over that, I think. And now you reported fourth quarter and 2020 year results. Were you satisfied with them?
Yeah, I guess we'll start with the fourth quarter and year-end results. You know, we had a very good fourth quarter. We had a bit of a stumble in the third quarter and had to restate guidance, and we got whacked for that. But, you know, it was all related to mechanical issues at the mine. Certainly, we're seeing excellent reconciliation of grade and recovery. So those two are keys, because if those aren't right, then you got a problem and nothing you can do to change it. Whereas mechanical problems, you can always fix. Yeah. During COVID, it's a little more difficult and takes a little more time, but I'm very happy with where we are now. We got most of the retrofits done in the fall, and then during our winter shutdown in January and February, we continued that retrofit and in some cases redesign of various aspects of the plant. And, you know, we got started up in March, a month ahead of schedule, and things have gone very well since then.
Fantastic. Super. So that means you're also satisfied with the first quarter this year already, because we are now 21st April. And so it's things are okay with you in the perspective that you had the shutdown because of the cold weather. You could fix everything. And so now you are poised to go full throttle, I would call it.
Yeah, as I said, you know, we monitor the weather. And if it had been minus 40 in March, we wouldn't have started stacking, but it warmed up to minus 20. And so we were very comfortable resuming stacking. And, you know, as a result of the stacking and the good fourth quarter we had, we produced over 26,000 ounces in January, or in the first quarter, compared to the previous year, where we only produced 10,000 ounces. So a real big step up. And, you know, we'll always be a bit of a seasonal operation until we get to year-round stacking. So our guidance will always be skewed to the second half of the year until, again, we get to year-round stacking, and then we'll get to steady state.
Mm-hmm, fantastic. That leads also to my next question, because you sold like over 40,000 ounces in Q4. And of course, if I would sum that up or add that up, we are coming out of 160,000 ounces for a full year. So your guidance is 180,000 to 200,000 ounces. So what have you changed, or let's put it that way, from where do you see those additional ounces coming, especially in the second half of the year?
Yeah, again, it's related to the problems we had in the third quarter, you know, the mechanical issues, and we don't anticipate that being a problem going forward. So we're very comfortable with our guidance.
Mm-hmm. Super. Can you say something to the, let's say, expected AISC, also maybe to some sustaining capital investment, stuff like this, please?
Yeah, a couple things there. This is a high sustaining capital year for us. We're putting in a truck shop and a water treatment plant. Now, the truck shop was a delay from last year, so it got moved into this year because of COVID. And then the water treatment plant was always there. So this will be higher than normal. We have those two expenses that we won't have in future years. So we've provided guidance for this year of between 1050 and 1175, all in sustaining. But I'm very comfortable that in future years we'll get that down.
That's a super health margin, I would call it. And if we are talking already about money, so what have you repaid so far? Have you done additional repayments this year already? And what is still the debt in the company, maybe in US dollars, if this is easier for you?
Yeah, you know.
Canadian.
I always have to be careful. I give numbers that are out in the public market, but we're sitting at roughly 150 million US in debt right now. We did make a $20 million payment that wasn't planned in January. We had enough cash that, and that's going to be our focus over the next 18 months is pay down debt. I'm a bit old fashioned, growing up, I don't think my father ever had debt. And so I'm uncomfortable with too much debt. So, our goal this year is to get down below 100 million in debt.
Wow.
And then we'll feel a lot more comfortable and sleep better at night. And once we're down below 100 million, I think then we start looking at paying a dividend.
I'd love to hear that.
Well, I'm a little bit, selfish myself because I'm a large shareholder of Victoria. I love dividends.
Me too, absolutely. And I'm also a shareholder. And I was inside myself, I was smiling when you said some minutes ago that you had a hit last year after that third quarter and fourth quarter, which was not like what it's supposed to be. And honestly, I was using that to buy shares at $10.80. I loved it. That was great.
Well, good on Super. You. I like to
yeah,
hear those
thank
stories.
You. Yeah, no, and with dividends, I mean, this is also something I love to hear because for me, it's also important. It's great to have a payout without working.
Yeah, well, and there's been a fair change in our shareholder registry over the last 6 months, mm-hmm. and you weren't the only one that took advantage of that dip. Groups. There's a couple new groups that hold Victoria, a group out of Brazil called Fourth Sail. They've been buying in the market and they took advantage of that share price. So, groups like Sentry out of Toronto, they doubled their position when they saw that dip. So, there's some smart people out there like you, and the goal is to make everybody money.
Yeah, I can really assure you, I know some of my Swiss friends and followers, they called me also and they bought. So we are all happy. That's important. Let's come a bit more to the future. I read in one of your press releases, I think it was in the project 250K for 2023. So I could imagine 250,000 ounces production.
Yeah, now that the mine's up and running properly, we're having a good hard look at everything. And I challenged the team and said, let's see how we can get up to 250K by 2023. Now, a big part of that is getting to year-round stacking. And, we've got two winters under our belt now, and we've seen where the problems are. And, one thing we don't want to do is freeze a section of the leach pad, but now we're getting a big volume in the leach pad, and we think that's very unlikely. And we've learned how to handle it. If you get localized freezing, you get in there and you rip it with a dozer. So we're very confident that by 2023 we'll be stacking year round. The other, area is we have a shear zone that runs through the middle of the deposit. Mm-hmm. And we found that when we drill and blast as part of the mining, that material breaks extremely finely. So it doesn't need to be crushed before it goes on the leach pad. So we think there's an opportunity, and we're doing the test work right now, to green off that material either before the primary crusher or between mm-hmm. the primary and secondary crushers and transport it directly to the leach pad.
So what have you planned for this year? What do you like to achieve?
Yeah, we actually have two programs. Mm-hmm. One is drilling off Eagle at depth. And, you know, the current pit is planned to 350 meters. We have four holes that go down to 650 meters. So we know the mineralization carries on. But we think we should have a better understanding of that because it may make more sense to increase the strip ratio now so that you can go deeper in the future at these current prices. As well, you know, we have had a lot of interest by other companies in acquiring Victoria. So we want to make sure we know the full resource if somebody lobs a hostile bid over the transom and we have to react to it. So we're drilling, I think it's 14 holes, 10,000 meters, down to 850 meters. So another 500 meters below the currently planned pit. And that work is about 50% done now. So should see the results of that late in the summer or early fall with both the results and an update of the total resource. Mm-hmm. And then in terms of regional exploration, as you mentioned, we probably have the best new discovery in the Yukon in Raven, which is out to the east. It's on the southeast corner of another large granodiorite intrusive with very similar characteristics to the intrusive that hosts Eagle. So we got out there in 2018, put in a road, got some trenching. You know, the first trench was over 100 meters at 3.5 grams. So that got the team pretty excited. We did more trenching. We got out there in 2019, drilled a few diamond drill holes, and got many multi-gram intercepts right on surface. 2021, we had a shortened program because of COVID. We never got boots on the ground until July, but we drilled some 30 holes, and we've now stretched this discovery to over 750 meters of strike, and it's open in all directions. We've only drilled it down to about 180 meters. So this year, we're currently opening the road right now, and we'll be drilling before the end of April. We already have two drill rigs out there. We left them from last year in a large exploration camp. So we plan to drill over 14,000 meters out there and spend roughly $8 million this year. And our goal is a maiden resource by the end of the year.
Wow. Phew, that's fantastic. Super. So tons of work to do for this year, I would say. And yeah, John, what can I say? Keep it going. Keep us hitting with good results. And yeah, produce as much gold as possible.
Yeah, one thing I should add, Jochen, is, you know, I think in previous interviews, I've talked about COVID. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I always have considered it the highest risk to our business. The risk hasn't gone away, but I'm pleased to report that we've now vaccinated roughly 75% of our workforce. Wow. We've worked closely with the Yukon government, and they've been amenable to providing us with the vaccine, and we've been administering it on site with employees that were there and any new employees. As a matter of fact, I got my first shot a couple of weeks ago, so... you know, it's still a risk. We're in major lockdown out here in British Columbia and in the Yukon, but there is light at the end of the tunnel.
Yeah, that's fantastic. Glad to hear that. Glad that you got your first shot. Also, I have mine now for over 5 weeks, I think. So it does not hurt, and it's really not horrible. But you feel much better and safer.
I had no reaction to it, And our experience on site, we're using the Moderna vaccine. Mm-hmm. I would say no one had a reaction to the first shot. and probably 50% have a small reaction to the second shot, where they feel a little bit of flu for about 6 to 12 hours, but nothing other than that. And we've vaccinated over 350 people now. So
super. No, glad to hear that. And I had only some headache. That's it. Yeah. But super. Fantastic. Glad to hear that. Thank you very much. So I would say everything is on the right path and you are poised and ready to fulfill the guidance this year, at least I would call it. And I really look forward to your exploration results. John, thank you very much. All the best. And I have a good feeling that we talk soon.
Okay, great. Thanks, Jochen. Have a good day, everyone.
Thank you very much. Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, that was John McConnelly, CEO of Victoria Gold, Yukon's latest and one of the real large gold producers. And you heard it, with a lot of money in the bank, early repayments again this year of $20 million, and the debt is down to $150 million, and below $100 million, they want to restart to pay dividend. I think ratings are between $21 and $25 already. And I would suggest you really have a good look onto this fantastic company and make sure you get some stock. Thanks for watching us and bye bye from Switzerland.